How's it going, everyone? My name is Kel, also known as Red Zone Rogue, and today we're going to be talking about one of my absolute favorite Flesh and Blood formats, and that, of course, is Ultimate Pit Fight. This is the Ultimate Pit Fight Round the Table Cross Talarian Community College product. Well, it's called Round the Table, and I think now is the perfect time for you to give it a shot, to try it out, and see why exactly it is one of my absolute favorite ways to play Flesh and Blood. And it all kind of stems back to just the enjoyment of playing, one, a really, really good game with really, really good game mechanics, but also having that awesome social experience that a lot of Magic the Gathering Commander players will know. If you didn't know, I am also someone who enjoys Commander. I have a myriad of Commander decks. One of my favorites is a Marin of Clan Nel'thoth, but it's really a Dark Depths deck where I try to Berserk Merit Lodge or give her Infect. So that's the kind of player I am. I have some weird janky stuff too, but giving Merit Lodge Infect. Anyway, so we're going to be talking about Ultimate Pit Fight today. So, what comes in this Round the Table box set? Because I do believe this is probably the single best product that Legend Story Studios and Flesh and Blood has just ever made. I think this is not only a great way to start playing Flesh and Blood around Ultimate Pit Fight, but just a great way to start playing Flesh and Blood in general. So, you can typically find this entire box set for about $57 on TCG Player currently. The MSRP is a little bit higher than that, but you can find them at $57, and that is actually quite a good deal for what you get inside here. So you get this box. It's a storage box, right? It's just kind of, you know, like your standard storage box. It also comes with a playmat. It's a very nice quality playmat. If you buy Ultra Pro playmats, expect that level of quality. This isn't the selling point. It's just a nice, cool thing that it comes with. It comes with the playmat. It's a neoprene rubber playmat. And then the best part is the decks that it comes with, right? So the Round the Table box set comes with four fully built, pre-constructed decks that have full play sets of high rarity cards. No legendaries, but it does have like play sets of good staple majestics for the Ultimate Pit Fight format. And you have all four decks ready to go from the box. So for $57, you get a playmat, which is usually about $30. You get four decks, and it is just such a really, really good deal. So you can even be like, okay, hey, maybe the decks are valued at like, we'll just say the decks are like $15 each. There you go. It's already a really good deal in of that. So we'll talk about the decks in the product, and we'll talk about basically why I think you should try Ultimate Pit Fight out, whether or not you're a Flesh and Blood player already, or if you are maybe a player coming over from Magic the Gathering, maybe you like Commander. So what makes it so good is this box set. So you get all four of these decks. This box set heavily encourages table talk. It encourages politicking within the game. You don't have to engage with it that way, but it encourages it, and I think it makes it so much fun. I play Commander like maybe several times a month, and this is some of the most fun I've had playing multiplayer card games. It is just incredibly enjoyable with the pre-constructed decks right out of the box. So you have decks like Ira, the ninja here. This is the deck that is probably the closest to your standard Flesh and Blood deck. It's a really, really solid like 1v1 style deck that you can take and upgrade this into like a skirmish style decks. If you wanted to, you know, play at like your local level, this would be the deck to do that with. However, it's still really, really fun in multiplayer, right? And you're going to be like a pretty big threat that other players are going to have to play around and deal with. You're going to also play up against, or maybe as, the professor here. This is a mechanologist class. I should say that this first deck is ninja, and it plays, I would say, aggro. So this is like a more of an aggressive style deck. Go wide, death by a thousand cuts, combo your ninja stuff together. This deck, the professor deck, is a mechanologist deck. This deck is more of a mid to late game style deck. I don't want to exactly say control deck, but essentially, in Magic terms, this is like a ramp deck, I would say. So you basically suit up the professor Professor Teklavasan here with mech armor. And as you suit up your mech armor, you get more powerful, and the mech armor does better stuff the more players are in the game. So this deck actually encourages you to keep players alive until you can fully assemble your mech suit and get the maximum value out of it. This deck is very, very strong and has won a handful of games that I have played in. Do not underestimate the Professor deck. Now we also have probably the fan favorite. This is Melody the Bard. This is a control deck for sure, but more specifically, this is a group hug style deck where you give everyone like tokens and draw cards and life and you buff people. But what you're secretly doing is you're building a cache of copper, and then you crack all of your copper. You cash on all of your copper all at once and do a big finale. And the card finale cares about cards that you pitch, and you pitch the cards to cash in your copper. And so you'll have a big finale and you just one-shot someone. Do not underestimate the Bard either. Bard, in my opinion, is almost, I wouldn't say kill on sight, but don't trust the Bard. The Bard player will try to entice you with their Bardly wiles, and they'll be like, ooh, do you want to draw a card? Do you want some tokens? But they're really just setting themselves up to smash you later. Bard is very strong. There's only 6 attacks in the deck. The deck really plays more of like a group hug style thing. Everyone gets stuff until a Bard kills you. And then last but not least, we have Bravant the Guardian. This is more of, this one also feels kind of ramp style, if you want to put it into Magic the Gathering terms. This deck blocks really, really well. It's kind of defensive. However, you use that defense and turn it into your offense. So you'll get like tokens when you use these block cards, and then the tokens will pump up your attacks. And you also have other cards that will kind of like pump up your attacks by a big amount. So the way this deck kind of plays is you like block a bunch, play a little defensive game, and then you put down a card that's going to buff up your next attack on your next turn, and then you just punch someone for double digit numbers. Yeah, this deck is actually really, really sweet. It also introduces a fairly new mechanic to Flesh and Blood in that, well, I guess it is an entirely new mechanic, and that is this mechanic that lets you block for other people. So if someone's being attacked a lot, you can politic, and maybe the Bard will like give you a lot of buffs if you block for them or something like that. And maybe the ninja player is being a little too aggressive against someone, and you can bargain with that someone as Bravant and then block for them. The Bard deck also has ways to prevent damage from any player, and the Professor deck has ways to attack every player at the same time or to attack very specific players. Yeah, there's a lot of table talk. It's just so much fun. I cannot recommend this product enough. And I also, just as an extension of that, I can't recommend that you try Ultimate Pit Fight out. And that's kind of the point of this video. I just want folks to try it out. I think it is genuinely some of the most fun I have had in card gaming in recent memory. It is super, super fun, whether you're playing with your own built decks for Ultimate Pit Fight, or if you're playing with this Round the Table product specifically. I think it is worth a shot, and I think it is definitely worth talking about here. So yeah, that's basically all I have to say. Round the Table. Really, really cool product. Really good value, actually. 4 decks for like $57 with the playmat is actually just really, really good value. And like I said, these decks are not just kind of like common bulk cards. There's some cold foils in here for sure. There's some rainbow foil, like, you know, heroes and stuff. But what's really cool is that they put full play sets of all of the Majestics in here. And some of them are like I said, Ultimate Pit Fight staples. So for example, in that the Bard Melody deck, it comes with 2 Crazy Brews as well as 2 of the Cokes of Commotion. So like, here's the 2 Crazy Brews, and it comes with 2 Cokes of Commotion, which is an older Flesh and Blood card, but many would consider it a Ultimate Pit Fight staple. Like, this is just a awesome, super, super cool card. And then it comes with 2 of like the more signature cards, like her final act there. Melody herself comes in rainbow foil. You can't tell quite because my lighting isn't great, but it looks really good. And then her mandolin, oh, this is a fiddle specifically, is cold foil. Really cool card. So yeah, highly recommend this product. Highly recommend trying Ultimate Pit Fight out. It is an absolute blast, and just a nice refreshing way to play Flesh and Blood. Recommended for any Flesh and Blood player, or if you are on the fence, maybe you're a Commander player, I recommend trying it out. It's a lot of fun. So, yeah. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. And let me know what you think, if you've tried Ultimate Pit Fight Out, in the comments down below. And we'll see you next time.